Hello, I'm Luke Hatfield. I'm joined by Matt Mayer here at the Express and Star. Matt, we're really getting into the crux of deadline day now. What is the situation with Aston Villa?
Well, they're still keen to bring in a striker. Mm-hmm. That was the aim at the start of the transfer window.
Yeah.
You know, when, you know, Scott Hogan wasn't scoring goals. Mm-hmm. Obviously, a lot has changed this month for Villa in a good way. You know, they've won five games straight. And Steve Bruce said on Monday that his need for a striker is less pressing now.
Mm-hmm.
But I still think they want to bring somebody in.
Yeah.
Simply because they haven't got a huge amount of depth behind Hogan, mm-hmm. Kenny Davis. Gabriel Bonglahor is probably his third choice. They've been injured for much of the season, keeps picking up England injuries.
Yeah.
Then you've got Rushen Hepburn Murphy, who's not started a first team game yet.
Mm-hmm.
So they have been keen to bring in a striker. Leonardo Ulloa from Leicester was the top choice. That was the top target. I think Villa, maybe a couple of weeks ago, were pretty confident they were going to get Ulloa in.
Mm-hmm.
It didn't happen. He went to Brighton, you know, a club where he'd been before.
Yeah.
The new target now, or a deal that I understand they are kind of working on or working towards, is Lewis Graben,
mm-hmm.
at Bournemouth. You know, not entirely sure how far along the line they are, but they've obviously got to get a certain way along the line because we've only got a few hours left. He's a player that was mentioned back before the transfer window on a possible permanent deal.
Mm-hmm.
That was never going to happen. Villa just don't have the funds. But Graben has proven in the Championship. He scored 12 goals in 19 appearances for a very, very poor Sunderland team earlier in the season. Went back to Bournemouth. The talk was that he was going back to Bournemouth to be sold in a permanent deal.
Mm-hmm.
That just hasn't transpired, and I think the chances are now that he is going to be allowed out on loan for the second half of the season. He doesn't feature in the plans down on the south coast for the Cherries. Cardiff also interested,
mm-hmm.
so we'll see what happens there. But Graben is kind of the new name in the frame. I think there are other targets, but Villa are after a very specific type of player, so mm-hmm. that does kind of limit them as well.
Certainly knows where the net is, doesn't he? I mean,
and you know that Sunderland particularly, I know they're not particularly great at the moment, but certainly the early weeks of the season were very poor, and he was the one shining light in that side.
Yeah,
he scored a lot of goals for Reading last season. I think he scored he might have got a couple at Villa Park.
Mm-hmm.
My memory fails me there. You know, back in last April, when Reading really ran rings around Villa in that game. He for me would be a very good addition to what is already, let's be honest, a very strong squad. But you just don't want to run the risk, you know, of maybe an injury to Hogan, which keeps him out for 3 or 4 weeks.
He has had injury problems
and
as well.
And he has, you know, and as well as he's playing at the moment, and, you know, you can't say, you know, he deserves to keep his place.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you just, 3 or 4, a little injury at this stage of the season with such a little amount of time left, you know, in terms of weeks, still a lot of games, you know, that can have a big impact. You know, I think Keenan Davis did superbly well for the mm-hmm. first half of the season. We were discussing yesterday, you know, a player, you know, you look at his first game against Norwich, what an impact that had for Villa.
Yeah.
He's one of the most significant players this season for Villa. You know, and I think he's had a bit more of a rest now. He looked good last night at Sheffield United when he came on,
mm-hmm.
but they just do need that, you know, that other option, that backup, because you know the games are going to get tighter, and it's going to come down to the fine margins.
That's it. And Villa, obviously, a very attractive proposition at the moment. I mean, one of the form teams in England, other than Wolves. I mean, in terms of a Championship, Derby are ahead of them, of course, but Villa are on this great streak. I mean, if you were Graben, you'd probably consider Villa, one of the premier destinations in the Championship right now.
Well, I think anybody would. Villa are in excellent form. It's interesting you mention Wolves, obviously.
Yeah.
You know, they've been the standout team in the Championship, but Villa had a dreadful start.
Mm-hmm.
You know, 1 point from the first three games. After those first three games, the difference between Villa and Wolves is basically the game that was played at Molyneux, which Wolves won, albeit mm-hmm. convincingly. But Villa's form has not been far off
mm-hmm.
Wolves' pace since then, albeit they've still, you know, they've not been able to close the gap.
Yeah.
has remained, you know, what it is. But you know, a huge win for Villa on Tuesday night. You know, a performance, you know, wasn't as classy as some of the performances we've mm-hmm. seen from them of late. It was very much substance over style,
yeah.
and it looked like they were heading for really good points. But then to win the game in the manner they did, a superb goal, for me, goal of the season so far, just the execution from Robert Snodgrass, and also just the timing and what it meant, you know, it just raised those kind of belief levels. Those nights when, you know, on which it's a cliche, but when promotions are won, and you look back, we may look back on that as a decisive night, you know, just such a, you know, five consecutive league wins for the first time in nearly 20 years.
Yeah.
You know, the club's really, really on a high. And, you know, playing Burton on Saturday, you know, they go into that with huge confidence. So, you know, you just think it's going to come down to squad depth, this battle. You know, Villa, Derby, that's the way it's looking at the moment. Fulham in great form. Mm-hmm. Middlesbrough as well, I think, don't count them out because their squad is so strong. But that's what it's going to come down to.
That's it. And it was a massive game, of course, yesterday. I mean, and it's one of them where, like you said, it really does give a confidence boost to not only the players, but everyone who supports the club as well. Because, I mean, Sheffield United position they were in, it's opened a gap now between Villa and you know, the bottom of those playoffs where, you know, Sheffield United's seventh, trying to get into them playoffs. But that gap now has opened up.
Yeah, it has. And you know, that's something to look at as well. I mean, that for me, wasn't so much... Obviously, the reaction of the Villa fans, the travelling supporters, the players, you know, you could just see that there's that unity that just hasn't, you know, hasn't been there at Villa for so long now. And suddenly, you know, it's back. And, you know, Steve Bruce, I think, probably doesn't get enough credit because it's unseen work that he's done at the training ground, building that spirit. And you need the wins, you need the form, that has to come. But they're such a team that's together at the moment, and they don't flinch now, Villa. You know, for years they've been pushovers, and last night's the kind of game where Villa would have been blown away.
Yeah.
Maybe even earlier this season. I mean, you look at Cardiff, the results at Cardiff and Reading at the start of the season. That feels like years ago now, rather than only a few months. And it was a really physical contest last night. Sheffield United gave it everything. Mm-hmm. They're a really good side. But Villa stood up to it. You know, they weathered the storm. Mm-hmm. And that's what they've tended to do since those first three games of the season.
Yeah.
And having weathered the storm, they then found a way to win it. You know, and the reaction from the Sheffield United perspective, you know, it was almost as though they'd lost a cup game, you know, and I'm sure they'll bounce back for it because they've got a very good manager and a very good group of players, but it had that feel to it, you know, that kind of silence, disbelief at the end of the game. And huge for Villa in terms of confidence going forward. You know, and now just a point behind second place. I mean, it feels like they've closed the gap in the blink of an eye. I mean, it was only a few weeks ago we were saying, well, you know, it's probably playoffs at best, and now, you know, it's there for the taking.
Certainly is, and it was a ground out result. And one player who has really ground out their career at Villa, I mean, he's been up and down, Alan Hutton. There's news coming out regarding him today.
Yeah, it had been reported in a few places, and you know, it's my understanding now. As well, that you know, he's not going to be offered a new deal, and he's probably going to leave in the summer. The timing for this is strange. Yeah. I've got to admit, I would have thought that I would have been left to the end of the season. I get Villa's logic. He's 33 years old. You know, you do want to, you know, start moving on. Yeah. You know, if they got promoted back to the Premier League, would he be a player for them there? I'm not so sure.
Yeah,
but I mean, he's a huge fan favourite. And you've got to admire him because this is a player who's had, you know, he's never going to be considered a Villa great, but he has had one of the more extraordinary careers. Didn't play in the first team for 2 years. He was, you know, part of the infamous bomb squad under Paul Lambert. And that was mainly down to the fact that Villa were trying to offload him, get his wages off the books.
Yeah.
And yet he's come through that. He got back in. He earned himself a new deal. And Steve Bruce, I was actually talking about him in the week, you know, saying he's probably picked him more than any other player. I'm not sure that's statistically right.
Yeah.
But Hutton demands to get back in the side. Ahmed El-Mohamedy came in the summer. Villa had bought Richie Delap. He's seen up everyone. And now he's playing at left back, which is an unfamiliar position. And he's probably enjoyed in the last 3 or 4 months his most consistent form at Villa. So
he's keeping a natural left back out of the team.
He's keeping the Welsh international left back out of the team. So, you know, hats off to what he's done. You know, he'll go with a big send off from the supporters. You know, and hopefully, you know, he goes with having helped Villa get back into the Premier League. Because the other, I think the other thing for, with Hutton, mm-hmm. which kind of perhaps changed opinions up, you know, fan opinions towards him, what was in that relegation season.
Yeah,
he was probably the one player, or one of a, only a small handful of players,
who
could turn around at the end of the season and say, you know what, I gave everything. Mm-hmm. He was one who didn't, you know, didn't throw in the towel, who kept on going. And I think the fans see that and they appreciate it. You know, they appreciate honest players. You know, and that's what he is. You know, and he, like, ground out is a good word. He has really kind of worked, and despite being written off again and again, you know, has spent seven seasons at Villa Park, and fair play to him.
Yeah, that's it. And one final thing to touch on, of course, Benik Afebe was mentioned with a bit of interest with Villa. I mean, what's the deal? That is that going to happen? Because Wolves, of course, you know, they're the big link for him.
Yeah, I frankly can't see it. I mean, I think the issue there was, if the issue for Wolves is that they don't want to agree a permanent deal, mm-hmm. then that rules Villa out, because Villa aren't in the position where they can say, yes, we'll take him on loan and then buy him permanently, because they just don't have the funds. Mm-hmm. So that was always, for me, was a non-starter.
Yeah.
Unless, of course, Bournemouth changed their stance.
Yeah.
If they do that, then you've got to think, well, Afebe, with the feeling he's got for Wolves, it leaves Villa very much second favourites. Steve Bruce is out for a number nine. Mm-hmm. You know, he wants a player, you know, that can play that number nine role. And, you know, Graben, for me, probably fits the bill. I think there are other targets. It'll be interesting to see what develops over the next few hours. Mm-hmm. But you know, they're still keen to bring somebody in.
That's it. So looks like it could be a busy transfer deadline day with Lewis Graben, the latest man linked, and Villa keen to add a striker. For all the latest on there, make sure you stay with us at expressandstar.com.